Yo, what is good, Ethan? We back. It is Thursday, February 25th. We're here with another episode of Reselling 101. It's gonna be a little bit of sneaker review. You wanna kind of give some background on what the sneaker review is gonna be on?
I was about maybe these cool grays, these silver toes, and a nice daily review of the weekend coming up.
Word. Chris ain't here right now. You know, we ain't trying to get no bad juju from him on our sneaker apps. Nah, I'm playing. He's just busy, you know, swamp as always. Hardworking man. Yeah, so we just gonna have to do this ourselves and, you know, just talk about everything.
Yes,
let's get into the Z.
Let's get it.
So E, show off these cool grade threes, yeah. Since I asked out hard body.
There they are.
Word. How you feel about the quality? I know quality's been like the major, you know, point.
I don't know if you can see, but they're already cracked. Like,
oh yeah, they got some creasing. They got like some chips. Is that? Am I bugging out? The leather chipping? No. Like, look, the leather suede.
Look at this. Yeah, look at it.
So is it like fading, or is it like actual? Like, looks like a chunk is missing.
No, it's fading.
Oh, okay,
this piece
okay.
Because right
from here, it looks white. Like it's yeah. From here, it looked like it was a piece missing. I'm like, no way.
But this is like chunks. Like, the whole creases and chunks, like, that's so disappointing.
Hey, yo, what the fuck?
For sure that hasn't came out since, I think, 01 or 04. This quality has been, like, it's already creased. Like, what are you supposed to do? Are you supposed to wear it and not crease it? It's not possible. It's already creased.
Why treat the customer this way? Why? Because fuck them, that's why.
But going to our market, you going for $230, reasonable price, retail $190. As usual, you're more of a holder. So for all the OGs out there, I would hold it for a year. Because every year, OGs come out in February. They look like, oh, what happened to last year's OGs? And they're like, oh, let me get another pair. And then they boost up to $350, depending which shoe it is.
Yeah, of course. So what's your plan, E? Can you want me to pull up the StockX numbers and stuff so you can like kind of explain what happens with the waves of all this?
Yeah.
But so here's the last sales chart if you want to just go based off of this and, you know, just tell the people what's gonna happen over the next few weeks.
Yep. So specifically today, everybody got their pairs in from sneakers, including me. So right now is a plummet. So that $10 is gonna go back up to $230 within 2 days, 2 or 3 days. Hello?
Yeah, you good, you good.
Information. But going from the StockX, I know, can you pull up from the top? I don't know if you can see the amount. Now, like the, I don't know. You're good, you're good.
Oh, okay, my bad.
Yeah, I got you. The peak of the sale.
So, like, right here, right?
Yeah. So, you should have three, that's going to probably be the peak if you wait that year. If you don't wait that year, then it's not going to be that high within like 3 or 6 months. Word. You would have to wait that year to get that peak profit. If not, you're probably going to get around 3 tops within 6 months.
Yeah, so like this little range between like February 6th to 8th, right? Like the 270s, the 250s, 60s, 40s, like around there.
That median area. So you're going to get about around those sales. And like I said, the quality is not there. So people are not, the OG heads are not too excited. It's nice, but it's not like once they see the shoe, they're bad.
Nah, you know my motto when it comes to the new stuff. And there's something, an old version of it. Sell the new by the old.
Exactly. This is exactly how I would do it. People are planning to keep it.
Word. So, this usually releases like this, right? Am I bugging that kind of follow that same trend of that peak price of like, you know, the 350 for the most part?
Yep. Every February when the OG comes out, you add a hold. The Carmines, hold. Definitely hold. Those will probably be a little sooner, like Christmas time.
Yeah.
But for the cold grays, I'll wait a year.
Word. I know you're not crazy about holding, but you think you're going to end up holding maybe one if you can get your other hands on them? Or
Yeah. If I can get a 11.5 to 13, I will hold. Because you know those OGs. be having them size 13s, which I don't know how, but it happens.
Word. I mean, you know me. I hold because, you know, my situation is a little bit different. You're buying 24/7 every single day. I'm kind of just, all right, what's the hot thing? And I'll get here and there with some weird releases that just – some Kyries or something. I'm like, all right, I'm going to just sell these, like, right now to make some quick money.
Exactly.
You got anything else you want to show? Because I know you hit on a few different things. I'm still waiting for some shipments to come in because, you know, Nike don't love me.
These beautiful things. These silver toes.
How's the quality on those now?
These are beautiful. You can smell the leather. It's beautiful. These are high quality. This is what you're looking for. But they're ones. They love their ones, you know.
Yeah, the hype on ones is crazy. I was looking at the ones, these ones right here, and all three of them go for like 700 now. I'm like, why did I wear these? Why? Then the other part of me is kind of like, all right, I know why I wore them, and that's why they're going for 700 because everybody wants them. So
exactly. They want a new pair.
How do you think these are going to do? Cause I know the women's ones are a weird market.
So, like we discussed, you do not pay the high. I mean, thank God they're only at like 260. So it's a nice little come up. But last year, you know, that $1,000.
Let's not even get into this, bro.
We won't talk about it.
I'm still looking at that price. It's only in the 400 for the satin toes, but you know, we'll discuss that in another episode of what happened. I'll be a story for the people.
We won't be hurt though. We'll just continue on with these. These will go up. I want to say summer, not crazy, like a good $60 in the summertime. Cause
yeah,
you pull these out. Woo. Hey, these remind me of the gold toes.
Word.
But the woman's version, of course. But if you wait that year, it should go up 120 to nearly 200, depending on the size. I got 10 and a half, so you know the men's size.
Yeah, I got that 10 and a half, too, that I'm waiting on. And the ones, I don't know, the ones are just weird right now, bro. Like, the hype on ones is insane right now. So any one that you get, in my opinion, if you don't have to sell the one, I'm holding the one. I'm holding a retro one for a year minimum because retro ones, like I said, got these back in like 2016. These came out last year and Blue Moons came out 2 years ago, I believe, because you got the pine greens. So top three ones are going for seven something. The Origin stores are going for seven and the Blue Moons are going for seven now. So you give it a year or two and ones, you'll look at the price and be like, holy crap, what is going on?
Yep, and going exactly what you're saying, you know, you hold multiple years, it's a wrap, especially when they're still in style. They're going up at least, like you said, $400, $500 to that 700 range.
Word, and it just depends on the hype of the colors and stuff and how many pairs were released, how many people have actually killed the pairs that are out there. So
a lot of people wear ones. Like they next day, they throw them on, it's already creased. One new pair.
Oh, no, you know these are my two new pairs because I had the Blue Moon size 11 that I destroyed, and then I had the other top three ones that I went to fucking Gov Ball and everything. And
I was about to say.
In a little Uzi concert, but you know.
Quick story. We were talking about the top threes. He had one pair that was already used. He was like, you know what? Let me destroy these and I can get another one. That was when they just came out, so not that 700 range, but. He said, you know what? Let me just get another pair.
And luckily, I did it at that time. I got them for like, I think it was three something. I just sold another pair and like, I barely paid anything. So it was lucky timing because I have not, those are barely been touching the ground because I'm like, yo, I'm nervous as hell to even wear like my ones now.
Exactly.
But, yo, the UNC ones, exclusive access, how'd you do on that?
Nah. No bueno.
Yeah, I asked out too, but you know who came up? Clutch D. A plug.
That's 11.
I was like,
"That's the secret plug. That's the plug to the plug." Cause she just be unlucky.
Yo, the luck that she be having be crazy, dog. But you know, everybody needs that lucky charm in their life. If you ain't it, cause I've gotten lucky here and there, but I don't know how the hell she her I don't know. I'm about to pay for her account or something. I don't know.
Just pick a name and I'm going to put an exact name and see if it works.
I'll be like, yo, how much you want for your account? Yo, 300? All right, better than that here.
Get every single release.
So, yeah, that's another shoe that I think is going to go for some crazy money. If those come out March 6th, if I'm not mistaken?
I think so.
I'll double check something right now because we got to talk about these releases coming up and get some intake. So let me pull that up now. So today's Thursday, as we said. We had all those dunks, of course. Yeah, that went terrible.
From toddler to men's, just straight L's.
Tomorrow you got the Cosmic Unity, which is like a basketball shoe. How do you think that's going to do?
It's like a recycling. Yeah. Like a new recycling shoe. First colorway always goes nice. Not nothing crazy. $30-$40, less money. But a nice quick sell.
Word. You got the low Blazers. The Blazer hype is kind of dying slowly. Maybe it does good. If you get it on Nike, it's not bad because you can always do the free return. What's the worst that happens? You make some money. If not, save your money for Saturday because you got the Delomeo 95s.
Restart.
Yeah. You remember when I got the Delomeo Air Forces, how crazy those things were going.
Yeah, that box is beautiful.
It did that thing. You also have the Blazer Mid ready made. How you think those are going to do?
Surprisingly, they're going to go crazy. And I, at first, I was like, really? Like, they look trash. Those are the shoes that look terrible, but like we said in the past, as long as they have a name and they have some type of hype, people are going to buy them. So right now, I think they're sitting at 400, I think around, but exactly. That's at least 200 over. So it might not stay that way, but I think people are saying it's going to go 100 and up.
Retail is 160. I mean, minimum it's probably going to go for is 250, depending how many pairs are made. So,
and for those sneakers that you won't even think about keeping, I would just sell.
And then you got the fours. How do you think those are going to do? I don't know. The hype on these, I feel like, is crazy. But
like everybody's been saying, the peak Travis Scott's, because that brown color. Like you said, the hype is crazy around these. I don't know why. I mean, they're over. They're $200 retail. I don't know why they're not 190. They're limited, supposedly. Like, in stores is very limited.
Yeah, because I think Foot Locker, I think, is the only one that's getting it because I heard Champs isn't getting them.
Nope. So that right there shows you when you hear that Foot Locker exclusive, there's going to go for more money than a regular GR release.
Word. Then we go to March 3rd, next Wednesday. You got the Delta Brief Jordan, not Jordans, Nikes, which... Don't even waste your time. Yeah, Air Max 90s. There's like a Valentine's colorway. The Air Force just sold out quick. I don't know how you think about these. How you think these are going to do. So I know 90s, the hype on 90s kind of like.
It's very weird because they're coming out a month later. I mean, if they would have just released it Valentine's Day, they would have been straight. But you might be fighting for each other to sell these pairs. Like you might make $20, $30 depending.
Yeah, we're talking like $20-$30, but people got to remember too, you know, the fees on StockX can sometimes even you out quick and go, so, you know.
And again, if it wasn't for it being after Valentine's Day, you would have been straight, but they really messed up with that pushback.
Word. And then next Thursday, we got the low dunks that are like the City Market low dunks. If you get them, you get them. If you don't, you know, you can't be mad because it's impossible to get dunks right now.
Yeah, we won't even talk about that. That's for a whole another episode.
I think between me, you, and Chris, I think only one of us has gotten a dunk in the last year, and it was me on the second try Metacom dunks. Like,
yep.
Yeah, I don't think Chris has gotten a dunk either on Nike this year.
I can't remember the last time I got a dunk. I think it was a yellow preschool pair, and that's it.
Yeah, the yellow and green, right?
Those dunks. Again, another whole nother episode. We're going to break down why they're going for so much.
Yeah, bro. All right, so let's talk about this one that came out today, the VaporMax Evo. Were you shocked to see those sell out at $200?
Honestly, I'm not. Just because, like, everybody's hyper on them, which is weird because they're VaporMax. But I guess once they put a different style to them, everybody started to love them. Again, comfort, insane, really comfortable. The details on them is pretty sick. It's the first colorway of the Ecos, so you know that you're going for some money. I don't know how much you're going for, but like $280, $300 I want to pay for. Like, I wouldn't drop that money for a pair of Air Max ever.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen the VaporMax from the very beginning, so we know that that first flyknit is never going to be compared to ever again. Neither will VaporMax Plus, like the original colors, not like the new weird colors they're dropping every other week.
And spoiler alert to our viewers, they will pop. The bubble will pop eventually. Somewhere.
Remember Vinny's, yo? That bubble that was, like, stressed on the side. And, like, he was like, yo, I can't wear these. Oh, I'm too big. Dan, I'm going to let your skinny ass keep wearing these. I can't do this to myself.
Nope. They will eventually pop.
So, anything for Adidas? I know Adidas has been – I know the Yeezys, right, this weekend or next weekend?
The Ash Blues and the Ash Stone.
Word.
They're both releasing on Adidas Confirmed, I want to say, both of them. But
yeah, I know the Ash Blue. I'm got to check right now for the Ash Stone.
You guys seen that last release with the sand? I forgot to pronounce the second half of the name, but the sand ones?
Yeah.
Under retail. That's how bad they're doing.
Yeah, easy. I don't know. I feel like they're just dropping too many, and it's been a mess, especially because they all look so similar every week.
Those you just have to hold. When it comes to Adidas, you just have to hold them.
Yeah, the Ash Blues are in the confirmed that drop the 27th. They start the drawing at 11 in the morning.
Yep.
So, I mean, the Yeezy, that's a shoe, you know me. Once I get a Yeezy, I'm holding it because I already know it's not going to go for anything for the first, like, month. And if it's a black colorway, it will. But you got to let people just sell each other out as much as you can.
Yep. For the people watching, once he dropped the Yeezy reel, that bright green one, not the semi-frozens, the other ones, it was a wrap. Like, I haven't seen an Yeezy 350.
Yo, even before then, what really messed it up was that September release when they did the Cloud White and the Citroen on back-to-back days.
Yep. That is another shoe that really messed up Yeezy.
And the Cloud Whites now going for some bread, but they just all look so similar, bro. Like the Cloud Whites, you had the Yesheas at that time. You had the Citrons. You had the Lundmarks. You have the Zions, whatever the hell you're calling them. The brown version that came out over COVID. You had the Cinders that just look like a dusty black. Like they just all looking so similar that it's insane.
Exactly.
And there was even the new one, the Quantums, yo. Remember I got the blue ones? Yo, them going for like $50 on the retail right now.
Yep. Like, it's just we would never thought Yeezy would be this bad. How they started with the black and whites and the black and green and the black and red. Like, those going for thousands.
That Black Friday.
Yeah, now they're 200 under retail.
Under retail, 250, 280 if you're lucky. Maybe 300 a year later. Oh, man. But, yo, hey, money's money at the end of the day. You gotta get to it some way, shape, or form.
Profit is profit.
Word. So, Ethan, you want to talk about any in-store come-ups you've been making lately since, they've been dropping a lot of lows and mids?
Oh, yeah. I've been seeing these. There's a bunch. Finish line got the lows and the mids. Like, they're in Florida, they're sitting. So, you just walk in, they are sitting right now.
Must be nice.
I seen the royal mids, turf blues, turf orange, the yellow lows, all going for money. Surprisingly, the all stars. The all star didn't come out. It was supposed to be February. They didn't release it a little too early, but they're probably gonna stay at 180, which is really good for a pair of mids, black and white. Carbon fiber, really clean. They just come out with so many mids and lows that you just have to go in there, check, and see if they go for money. The last ones we showed two episodes ago, the band ones, still stay going for money. The royal ones, still going for money.
Word.
But again, either you're holding or quick sell, make your quick $20. It adds up. If me and Dan don't know anything, everything adds up. Buy three pairs, $60 right there.
And if you hold it, you're making like $100 each, $300 in a day, easy, depending on how long you hold them.
Exactly. It's a lot of profit to be made in the state, though.
Word. And we're going to have to keep an eye on All-Star Weekend for the NBA, because you know that's when people bring out their PEs, and that's been pretty interesting to watch over the last few years, which we'll probably do the next episode as it gets closer. I can talk about the ones from last year, because I still got a bunch of those from last year.
I think, yeah, exactly next week, right? Also?
Should be. Next week.
Next week. So we'll have an all-star, our favorite ones, you know, those big nines, those KD4 Galaxies.
The Kyries that he's been dropping over the last few years have been insane.
Yeah, these, like you said, the player additions, you just got to keep an eye on.
Yeah, especially because there's a few first-time All-Stars like Zion who might drop a PE35 or something. Jason Tatum might have a PE35. You got Donovan Mitchell who has his own shoe. James Harden. There's some options out there. So we'll break that down in another episode, and we'll definitely talk about what to look out for and what to cop, what to hold, what to sell quick. And, you know, hopefully Chris will be here to give his take on older releases that he probably got his hand on before and has seen money go for. So, it's been a pleasure talking this. I'm about to go watch this Knicks game right now.
Good luck, sir.
Yeah, we'll be talking about this tomorrow, and they released the other half of the schedule, so maybe we got another bet coming down the line.
I can't wait. I'm going to make a playoff bet with you and Chris.
All right. Yeah. So we'll do this tomorrow on the podcast. You feel me? We'll be there making this bet. All right, bro. Until then. Peace out.